Mississippi State took the second half option and kicked off to us. We had a first half that was almost perfect offensively. Defensively, we made one or two mistakes that allowed Mississippi State to get in the end zone. You see William Kent on the return of the opening kickoff. David Smith was fantastic. He threw for 290 yards in the game. There he hits Marco Battle on the first play from scrimmage, and we used a variety of protections and a variety of movement with our quarterback, Kevin Turner, who's gotten his first start. Kevin's from Prattville, Alabama, and has just done an excellent job of working in as a starter here as a freshman. Good hard running by Kevin there, which gets us down into Mississippi State territory. Here's David on the sprint out. Excellent throw, excellent catch by Marco Battle again for an 11-yard gain down to the 16-yard line. And here Murray Hill goes in on the sweep from 11 yards out, and it looks almost too easy. And this is where the illusion begins to build in the minds of the players. It is the coach's job to make the players understand that this can change very rapidly. You can see that we've got them all blocked. Murray virtually walks into the end zone. Our defense comes on the field and performs just as well. Here's Philip Doyle from Huffman High School. Of course, you're all aware of that. On the extra point, the score is 7-0. Here's the big tailback, Jesse Anderson, 6'4", 230 pounds. Spencer Hammond, an excellent play for a 3-yard loss there on their first play. Here's the draw play to the fullback, Young. George Bethune, who had a good day, makes that tackle, and then he's able to pressure the quarterback, Tony Schell. Tony Schell doesn't look very effective here in the early going, but that's an illusion, too. He was SEC Player of the Week a couple of weeks ago for throwing the ball well. He threw the ball extremely well when they scored 35 points on Georgia, and we're going to get a taste of how good he is in the second half. Lamon Russell, who continues to give us excellent play, makes a fine catch there from David Smith. Lamon's from over in Honeona. Marco Battle with another catch as we continue to throw and run almost at will here in the first half. Murray Hill with excellent running, making people miss. Murray gained over 100 yards on the day. The blocking continues to improve with our offensive line. David Castile, and David has been underused this year. We're learning more and more about his abilities. Howard Cross, who caught the ball so well in the game at Mississippi State. Howard has excellent hands, and when he concentrates, he's as fine a receiving tight end in terms of catching the football and putting it away as there is. We stressed to Howard that we needed him to catch the ball this week, and he did a great job for us. And there he is on the second touchdown, bringing the score to 14-0. Here's Mississippi State with the ball again. And they begin to move this time. Here's Anderson off the left side, tackled by Keith McCants. Keith McCants had another big day. Here's Tony Schell with the deep ball, and they hurt us with the deep ball twice. And their great wide receiver, Hadley, simply outran us there. They missed the extra point, which made the score 14-6. Now, we didn't move the ball on the next possession, and they're able to get it down for the field goal. And Joel Logan, who comes from our state up in Hamilton, is a teammate of Craig Sanderson. Joel makes a fine 49-yard kick there. I believe that may be his longest, and the score is 14-9. So Mississippi State was fighting to get back in the game all along. There's Kevin Turner on the bootleg again from David. And again, the Marco Battle in the first quarter ends 14-9. We'll be back with the second quarter after this. Second quarter here is one of the best quarters of the year for us, if not the best. We start out at 1st and 10 on Mississippi State's 38-yard line. Excellent blocking up front. A big hole for Murray Hill as he goes to the 24-yard line, a 14-yard gain. Larry Rose is having an outstanding year. John Fullmorgan, Howard Cross, and Roger Schultz doing well there. On the delay, there's Howard Cross again for 9 yards. Mississippi State with the ball again. Gang tackling there, led by Tommy Cole, who had another outstanding day for us. Here on 3rd and 8, you'll see George Bethune sack Tony Shell in the end zone. We'll have a replay. And it was good to have George back in the lineup. We missed him last week, although Steve Webb and Derek Rustin did a good job filling in for him, but George beats the tackle, excuse me, and we get the safety in the end zone. Now, we messed up the kick after the safety. It was a very short kick, and we didn't field it, so Mississippi State gets the ball back, and that was the one real downer in the second quarter. Anderson sweeps left. Kermit Kendrick tackles him for 1 yard gain. Here we are with Spencer Hammond and a bunch of other tacklers there. And on 4th and 1, Mississippi State fakes it. I thought this was a good call by Rocky Felker. They had an excellent chance to burn us for a big one, but John Mangum makes a big play and we get the ball back. 1st and 10 at the Alabama 35. David Smith, Lamon Russell, and Lamon working for the first down. And you'll see that the SEC officials do flag late hits, which is good. We were guilty of some things yesterday, as was Mississippi State, but the officials were on top of it for the most part. There's David again for 27, down to the 27. Murray Hill to the 3-yard line. Murray's disappointed with himself that he didn't get that in the end zone. David Castile, who had a tremendous day, 4 touchdowns. And this is something we discovered last week in practice, that David has a great gift for leaping. He has among the most powerful legs on the squad, and watch him as he leaves the ground here on the 4-yard line, actually almost the 5, and he lands in the end zone. If you young people that are interested in becoming a good football player, David squats with 525 pounds. You work on those squats and you can develop your abilities as well. Keith McCants and George Thornton there on the tackle. We're able to get Mississippi State stopped. And here's Murray Hill, who also, by the way, has great power at a body weight of 165 pounds. It's his strength that gives him his quickness. So he runs the punt back, and we end up down here on 2nd and 5 at the 25-yard line. Fine throw and catch. Greg Payne, who's having an outstanding year for us. David back in the pocket again, this time to Howard Cross at the 2. Fine concentration by Howard. And here with good time to throw, with a good play action fake, you can see that the defender's going for the jump, thinking that David has the ball, which gives David Smith time, that is David Castile has the ball. It gives David Smith time to set up, and Howard gets a chance to get open, and that runs the score with the extra point to 30-9. And we're still in the second quarter. So we're playing football the way Alabama ought to play football here. Now we pick up the action at 3rd and 1 at the 45. Phillips runs for the first down. Now we're at 3rd and 10 at the Alabama 43. George Bethune again on the sack. Get some help from Derek Thomas there. And we get the football back on downs. David Castile off the right side. Good patience, good blocking. Ball comes out on the ground there, and we certainly don't want that. On 3rd and 7, David Smith on the boot. Under pressure, gets it off. Amon has a little trouble controlling that one, but manages to get it up for the first down. Here's David Smith to Murray Hill on the short dump pass down to the 44-yard line. And as time runs out, we almost run this one in the end zone with the off-tackle play, the power play. We run out of time, and with 6 seconds on the clock, Philip Doyle comes on and nails the field goal and makes it 33-9 at the half. And we'll be back with the action of the second half after this. He can yell and scream all he wants to, but they have to believe this game is over, when in fact, it's anything but over. We come out, we manage to make a big play, get an interception, run it back to midfield, but there's an inadvertent whistle. But that guy that blew that inadvertent whistle did not begin to miss the tackles and to execute poorly the way we did, to play so poorly in the third quarter. We went from one of our best quarters to one of our worst, despite this fumble recovery by Keith McCants here at our goal line. We manage offensively, instead of knocking it off the goal line, to take a safety and give the ball back to Mississippi State. So it's 33-11, and Mississippi State is very much in the game. John Mangum with a good play there on Hadley in the end zone. Mississippi State's in a gambling mood like anybody is when they get behind. And bear in mind, our football team has not been far ahead at the half. Even the games that we've won by blowouts this year were close at the half where the pressure was on us. We've got to learn to put an opponent away and not play football like this and allow folks to run it in the end zone. Now suddenly it's 33-17. Mississippi State going for two. We bat the ball down. And so the score remains 33-17, but the momentum has shifted. And once you allow folks to get on track, they got good football players. They scored a lot of points on good teams earlier in the year. And yes, this is an Alabama highlight film, and we continue to see good plays by Alabama. But meanwhile, Mississippi State's making a bunch of good plays. That's Cole and Thomas on that one. Another field goal here by Logan. The offense is doing nothing during this span to keep the pressure off our defense. Mississippi State's going for it on fourth down, and all kind of good things are happening for them. Here's a great play by David Smith to get the ball off under pressure to Robert Stewart. Robert handles the ball well, but we don't sustain anything. Here comes Tony Shell back again. Excellent play by Osmond. Lee Osmond picks it off there and gets it to the 28-yard line. And we do get something going in this drive. David Castile on the little swing pass. Down to the 25, and we're moving. Here's David with excellent running on the off-tackle play. Down to the 2-yard line. And David Castile again over the top. Great block by Larry Rose right there, which is typical of the way he's played all year. You'll get to see it again. Roger Schultz doing a good job. Robert Stewart doing a good job. And so we run the score to 40-20 in the third quarter. We were only outscored 11-7, but it seemed a lot worse than that. And we let them get the momentum going. Back to the fourth quarter after these messages. We're in the fourth quarter now, and Mississippi State is definitely on a roll. Here's an excellent throw and catch by Tony Shell and Bolden. Another of their outstanding receivers. And our offense comes back on the field and can't generate anything substantive, and we end up having to punt the ball away. And here, on first and 10 from the 24-yard line, incredibly, we're beaten deep again. So now, suddenly, we're dealing with a 40-34 football game. And it is very much a game. Now, here's the key to building confidence in this situation. Going back to the example of a basketball game or any other kind of situation where you've allowed an opponent to climb back in because you basically went to sleep at the switch. At this point, the offense has got to get a drive going, has got to take it in and score points. And here's Lamon Russell delivering for us. You saw Murray Hill on an excellent run. You see Lamon Russell take it to the 7-yard line, and Castile knocks it in the end zone. This is what you do. If you don't do the first thing that you ought to do, which is to shut the door on them and never let this happen, and the next time we get in this situation, we'll handle it considerably better. But the good thing about our football team is that the offense and defense came together here in the kicking game, got Mississippi State stopped, broke on the ball. You see Keith McCants there. Sacked the quarterback. Did the things we should have done all along. Tony Shell out again under heavy pressure. Willie White forces him to throw the football. Keith McCants comes up with it. And we're playing football like we realize what we've done to ourselves here. So we score the last 13 points in the game. Excellent blocking on the trap. Excellent running by Kevin Turner. And once again, David Castile knocking the ball down close, just grinding it out. Here, third and one from the 8-yard line. Good blocking to get him into the secondary level. He runs through the linebackers. You see Roger Schultz, Chris Robinette, Larry Rose. And we're into the end zone with the winning margin. We all learned a tremendous lesson, and that's what football's all about. 53-34, let's hear the play.